This is Paradise telling you to break your internet radio cherry at CertifiedSound.net.
If you want a lover, I'll do anything you ask me to. And if you want another kind of love, I'll wear a mask for you. If you want a partner, take my hand. Or if you want to strike me down in anger, here I stand, I'm your man.
So yeah, more Dragon Con stuff. I think I didn't give you the full breadth of what's actually at Dragon Con for the kinky types. And I thought I would come back and just kind of revisit that and give you guys a few more details. So I think I want to start with what I'd like to call the year of the under corset. I was walking through the Marriott at about 2 a.m., maybe 2:30, you know, pretty early in the morning. And, of course, it is still bumper to bumper, as it were, or arse to arse, if you will. And here we find two lovely specimens of female womandom boobies, whatever, wearing half corsets with their breasts exposed, which, you know, yay breasts, with hearts covered over their nipples. You know, this is so that they can actually wear these things out in public, right? And there's an absolute huge crowd. And taking pictures and doing general, ooh, look at boobies things, right? But what really threw me off was there was a cat probably less than 2 feet away from what I've dubbed the Titty Twins, just sitting there, completely engrossed in his text messaging. Now, you could argue, you've seen one pair, you've seen them all, but this was a guy. And those were boobs. I don't care if you're gay, straight, bi, doesn't matter. These were some nice boobs on display. I mean, I'm not sure I can convey to you the proper quality of boobie, but these were good boobies. But that's not actually my only half-corset story. I also ran into a lovely, lovely young lady I had the opportunity to talk with, who was actually able to model these for one of the dealers, because she actually had tattoos over her breasts of, she called it an underbra, but really it was like these leaves that kind of just rolled up over her breasts, and they were, well, both the breasts and the leaves were very beautiful. Now, I wish I had pictures of all of these women for you, but not to harp too much on the boobies. Let me talk a little bit more about some of these other events that were at Dragon Con. So Friday night, we had the Write Sex panel, that's R-I-T-E, on how to write erotic. You know, now, this was of course followed up by the FetLife panel, you know, so you could take your newly found dirty words and put them on your profile. And I find it really kind of cool that there was actually a FetLife panel for Dragon Con to actually introduce people to the site and the services. And that I think that really actually speaks to the huge number of kinky people that are at Dragon Con. Now, the following night, we actually had the BDSM 101. And this was specifically how to transition from online BDSM to what it means to be involved in this type of relationship in the real world. And while I wasn't able to attend that, I think that's actually a really smart panel. And one of those kind of topics that I'm glad to see is getting addressed. Now, one other thing, and this is kind of just an amusing observation. All of this was done through the EFF track, Electronic Frontiers Foundation. So you have this mixed in with how not to get into the gaming industry and Busted the Movie and stuff on WikiLeaks. So I really thought that was kind of amusing, and the fact that this all found its way into, again, the online track. But, hey, we take what we can get, right? Next time, those the goth track will make a comeback, and they'll have some good kinky stuff in there, right? Right, goth track? Come on. Anyway, there was also a one more costume contest I forgot to mention in the previous podcast. In addition to the Masquerade Ball, which is the big costume contest, and the Comic Booth Babes contest, there was the After Dark costume contest, which I was unable to attend this year, which I am sorely regretting. Always entertaining. The year I did attend, we had a fairy who was pinned to a dissection board, and you can fill in the blanks there, but sexy fairy, not dissected fairy. And one last follow-up. So, we decided to go back to our friendly neighborhood porn store after the first Dragon Con podcast. Porncast? Anyway, the first soundbite on Dragon Con. And, it's not friendly, and it's just a porn store now, you know? Whatever was there is kind of gone. Although, it wasn't nearly as creepy as the last time we went. Anyway, I mentioned that I have a friend who is a manager at an adult bookstore. So, for those of you who are in the Atlanta area, here is the certified endorsement for the Inserection Focus Entertainments, or Inserection Adult Fantasy Store, at 932 Montreal Drive, Clarkston, Georgia, 30021. Again, that's Inserection in Clarkston, Georgia. And if you need directions, their number is 404-298-6663. All right, so there you go. I think I am officially done with Dragon Con. I've gotten it out of my system. And we'll be back to porn and chicken next week. So this is DJ Certified saying keep your spunk silky.